Hello everybody and welcome to the channel. Today I'm going to show you guys how to easily save and load data on Unity using player prefs. Player prefs are a built-in feature in Unity that make it super easy to save and load data with only one line of code. Player prefs allow for three different variables to be saved and loaded: integers, floats, and strings. However, you can easily make a bool variable by using an integer and set it to 0 if false and 1 if true. To access player prefs, there are some very simple functions to remember. The first is a function to set a value to a player pref. These functions are playerprefs.set int, and it takes in a key and a value, and then the same for setFloat and setString. The key is a string which is used to access a specific player pref, for example, highscore. The value is the actual value that you're giving to the player pref. This can be a regular number like 2 or 3, but it can also be a variable like score. The next player pref functions are playerprefs.getInt, which also takes in a key, and it takes in a default value, and then the same for getFloat and getString. These functions are used to read a player pref. The key argument needs to be the exact same as when you set the player pref. For example, highscore. The default value is the value the player pref gets when the key doesn't have a value attached to it. For example, 0. There are some other functions regarding player prefs, like playerprefs.deleteKey, which takes in a key, or playerprefs.deleteAll, but I think they are pretty self-explanatory. Now let's make a simple high score. Alright, so here I have my script. I have a private int called score, which is the actual score. Then I have a serialized field private TMP text called score text. Now if you're not using TextMesh Pro, this can be a regular text and you need to import using UnityEngine.ui. And I serialize this field so that I can make this field private, but I can still edit it inside of the inspector. And then on void on GUI, so whenever something that is related to UI happens, it will update this UI. So it will say score text.text, so the text that is attached to the actual score. Then it will say score plus the actual score variable dot to string. Don't forget the to string, otherwise it won't work. And then finally, I have a public void called change score, which takes in a int called value. And that just says score is equal to or plus equals value. So if this value is -1, then it will simply subtract 1. Now let's first add a new variable, which is going to be once again a serialized field. It's going to be a private TMP text, and I'm going to call this high score text. And then on our private void start, I'm going to set high score text dot text equal to. And now we're going to use player prefs, so player prefs, and we're going to get a integer because we're going to read a value, and that is going to be called high score, and the default value will be 0. So if we have no high score set, then it will just be 0. However, this will throw an error, so we're going to say dot to string because that converts us to its string, and we're also going to add high score and then plus this function. However, this still won't do anything because our high score isn't set yet. So on void on GUI, I'm going to check if our current score, so our score variable, is greater than playerprefs.getInteger, which is going to be once again the key high score with default value 0. And if that is true, we're going to set playerprefs.setInt, and that's once again still going to be high score, and we're going to set that to score. And then in here, under our score text updater, I'm going to copy this line and set it over here. And now I'm going to head back into Unity. And here you can see that if I go into the score script and I add my my score script, and I add my score text and my high score text variables, I go under the add score button, and here I drag and drop this score object in here and select my change score and set this to 1, and then go under the subtract score button, select the score function, and then set the change score and set this to -1, and I now press play. You can see that I'm getting some errors, but that doesn't matter. That's not because of my script. If I now press the +1 button, you can see that my score goes up and my high score goes up. But if I now press -1, then my score goes down. And because it's smaller than my high score doesn't go down. And then if I increase this, then the high score goes up again. And if I now reload the scene, you can see that the high score stays, and once again we're getting that error, but that's because of Unity, that's not because of my script, so don't worry about that. But once again the high score stays, and if I go up, you can see that it goes up too, and we can make this go very high up. But yeah, that was basically how player prefs work. If you guys want to see how to save more data, for example using JSON or a different method, then please leave it in the comments, and I'll see you guys in the next video.